video. Welcome back to my channel. It's your girl A-Marie coming back to you guys live with another video. Before we start this video, make sure you give it a thumbs up. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel. Be a part of the A-Team if you haven't. Don't forget to turn on your post notification bell so anytime I do a video, you guys will be notified. Y'all gotta pardon my music in the background. Y'all know how I love my 90s old school music. So, y'all, but I'm back. And I had a little mini break last week from the kitchen, but I'm back like I never left. So today's video, guys, we're going to do a bacon stuffed pepper chicken breast, some green beans with my smoked turkey, and some rice. So without further ado, let's get cooking. What I'm going to do is I'm going to cut my pepper, and I'm gonna cut it in nice strips. We don't want the seeds though. But we want every other part of the pepper but the seeds. So we're going to trash you. Okay, and then I'm just going to, I know that was weird, no judging. I'm kind of in my feelings, guys, only because I need to get me another cutting board. The other cutting board I have, I need to save it for my chicken. So that's what I'm going to do, is save it for my chicken. So I'm just going to put my peppers that are already, I've cut up, and I'm going to put them on my plate. And that's what we're going to do. So while I'm finishing doing these peppers, guys, when we come back, the peppers will be done and cut, and I done picked the wrong part up. So we will be back, guys. If you guys can just give me a little minute, we will be good to go. And I don't want to do the rib part. That part's not good, so we don't want that part. All the other parts we do want, so I'm just gonna. My cousin Chanel was saying, anytime you have a sticker on your vegetables, instead of peeling it off, you want to cut it off. Because just because you peel it off, what she said? She said something about the wax from the sticker or something is still on the vegetable. So we're just gonna cut that off. And I'm just gonna finish, cutting the rest of my bad boy pepper. Again, guys, we don't want the seeds. You can leave them seeds out of there. Cause nobody got time for that. And yes, guys, make sure you wash your vegetables before you start cutting and dicing and using them and all that jazz. So I'm just going to come in here and just slice my peppers like I was doing from the get-go. And when you guys return, our peppers will be cut up. We don't have to worry about our onions because they are already diced. Winning. I bought them like that from Wally World, as a matter of fact. So, just got my peppers on my plate. And I'm just slicing away, guys. And I'm telling you, this is such an easy, it's an easy recipe, but like my best friend, like her meals and her dishes and her recipes, a lot of steps. A lot of steps. So this is going to be my first recipe with more steps than we normally do, just because this is a different recipe that I'm doing. I don't know, guys. I had my chicken breasts and thawing in my refrigerator and stuff. And I was thinking to myself, like, everybody does like the stuffed chicken breast, but
okay, guys, so over here I have a little skillet and I just have some of my sunflower oil. I've been telling you guys about this from previous videos. I don't use vegetable oil and canola oil. It's not good for you. So I use olive oil, but I'm trying something different, and this is sunflower oil, virgin sunflower oil. And I got this from Walmart, and y'all know I got it backed up underneath the sink, so don't have to worry about that. But yeah, guys, over on my stove, over medium high temp, I got my skillet ready because I'm going to add my vegetables, because our vegetables is going to be the stuffing that's going to go in our bacon stuffed pepper chicken breast. So we're going to get that together, and I'm going to start adding in my peppers. You're supposed to hear a sizzle, but it's going to get sizzled anyway, so it's all kind of gravy. It's all good and gravy. And you're hearing it talk already. That's exactly what we like. So I'm about to get me my little wooden spoon. Do y'all hear that sizzle? I told you, just give it a little bit of time. It'll definitely do what it's supposed to do. No worries. Just a little bit. Okay, I got my peppers in here, and I'm going to add some of my onions in here. Just like maybe 2 or 3 tablespoons. You know, not a whole lot. But a little goes a long way. Then we're gonna add some garlic. I don't know, guys. I was telling my mom the other day, I love peppers and onions. And I'm starting to notice now that I'm like a little older and got kids and stuff on my own, that I really do use it a lot in my cooking. So we just got some garlic powder. You feel me? Because we need to season up these veggies. And this is my all-purpose seasoning. I love this, guys. I got this from Walmart. It's literally everything. OMW. And then we got a little onion powder. Feel me? Just a little bit. We got a little bit of black pepper. Okay. And then we have some parsley. I don't know. It's this beautiful color. Those beautiful specks with that green onion is going to make that pop when I tell you. Okay, guys, I'm going to get my wooden spoon, and I'm just going to make sure I saute my vegetables. You feel me? And, guys, another thing, while I'm letting these do their thing, over here, and I had dipped my own little seasoning, and it's basically everything that we just did for our vegetables. So it's like a teaspoon of onion powder, a teaspoon of garlic powder, 2 tablespoons of the all-purpose seasoning, a teaspoon of black pepper, a teaspoon of parsley, and that. So we're going to use this seasoning for our chicken. So we got our chicken breast, guys. And listen, guys, I don't know what it is, but it is so much better when you prep. When you food prep, it's so much better. Like, I told y'all, I already got my cheese shredded, tucked away in the refrigerator. It's chilling in the fridge, cooling. And then I have my chicken breast that I've already washed. I've cut up all that fat. So all we're going to have to do is just put everything together, right? Easy, guys. Easy. So these smell so good. Oh, another thing, guys. Got a little bit of chicken broth. I don't know. I feel like this is kind of like how I do my cabbage, except it's no cabbage, no butter, no meat, no potatoes. But the peppers, the chicken broth, you feel me? The garlic, it's all still good and gravy. So this is going to give it some extra flavor. Guys, that is going to be so good when you bite, when you cut that chicken breast and you got the cheese and the veggies and then the bacon wrapped. And y'all know turkey bacon is where she's at. Y'all already know. So I'm just going to let these finish sautéing really nice. And guys, they smell so, so good. Oh my gosh. Okay, so while my vegetables are doing their thing, okay, I'm just going to leave them alone. And I'm going to jump into the chicken. So Make sure you guys stay tuned. You're watching Amarie TV. Guys, so now we're going to start our chicken. So, I have my gloves. Y'all know I do not, I still hate touching raw meat. Don't judge. But, I don't know, guys. I know y'all hear the music in the background. Y'all know how I feel about my 90s R&B music. I'm such a 90s girl. Take me back to the 90s, please. Y'all, take my ring. Been a minute since I had to put on some gloves. Sheesh. There we go. Okay, so, okay guys, so in this container here, okay, I have my chicken breast. Remember I told you guys that I had already washed my chicken and I cut everything. All that nasty fat, we got rid of that. So what I'm gonna do is I have to make pockets to put our vegetables and our stuffing in our chicken breast, okay? So I have me a piece of my chicken breast, right? And I have me a paring knife. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna cut, but not cut so deep where I tear my chicken, because I just want a nice little pocket. Want to make sure you keep everything together. Nice pocket, guys. Nice little pocket. Okay, guys, this is our last one. Ooh, perfect. It's fine. It's all good and gravy. Okay, this is gonna be our last one.
No,
we're going to turn this side. Okay guys, so we just seasoned our chicken in the inside, right? This is where our vegetables and our cheese is going to go. So we season inside all of our pockets really good and nice. Okay, so now we're going to season our chicken on both sides. Then we're going to flip our chicken. And then we're going to do the other side. We want seasoning on this chicken. Y'all know how I feel about my seasoning. And I'm just going to rub that all over that chicken, just like that. This is why my gloves are coming in hand perfectly. Like, perfectly. Chicken, and we're going to do the same thing we did on the front, we're going to do on the back. We're going to season, take our spoon and just sprinkle, and we're going to rub it all in. like you're massaging. Just massage it real good. And y'all seen how much we had in our bowl with that seasoning? Y'all, we got 4 chicken breasts. You hear me? Do y'all hear what I'm saying? When I say a little goes a long way, yeah, y'all, some of that. Okay, so we're gonna just take the rest. There really ain't nothing in there, but we don't wanna miss. Okay, guys, so now that we have butterflied our chicken, after seasoning our chicken, we season the pockets inside. Right? We seasoned the front and the back. Now we're going to start putting in our ingredients for our stuffed chicken. So my first layer, y'all know I got a clean hand. My first layer I'm going to put in here is going to be the cheese, okay? Then we want to take some of our pepper mixture. With our peppers and our onions, right? Y'all, and it's laying perfectly on that cheese because those peppers are still warm because we just got them off the stove. That doesn't look beautiful. God. Then I'm going to put a little bit more cheese. Closer, like that. Okay. Then we're gonna go to the second one. Same thing. We're going to put some cheese right in that pocket. That's why I said y'all gotta make sure you don't cut the breast all the way in half, because you're not gonna be able to have your pocket with your filling. The pockets is what makes these stuck. You know what I mean? So we got our cheese. We got our beautiful pepper mixture. And y'all, I am being so careful when I tell you this is not touching this meat. And our onions and our garlic. Y'all. Okay? And we're going to tuck that in too. And if some spills, it's okay. Okay, if you get a little messy in the kitchen, you just gotta stay sanitary in the kitchen. That's the thing. Pull that right over there like that. Cheese. Oh, y'all, I didn't add my little extra piece of cheese. Y'all wasn't gonna tell me? Hey, Marie, you forgot your extra layer of cheese, what? Stuffing our chicken, I have an iron skillet with some of my sunflower oil, and we're just going to brown it on both sides. Don't forget, y'all know I forgot about the bacon, and we're just going to let it brown for a few minutes on each side, and then we're going to finish cooking it in the oven. So make sure you guys stay tuned. Okay, guys, so what I have is my skillet is getting nice and hot, and I just took my bacon, right? And I just wrapped it around that chicken. And I got me a little toothpick. I hate using this eye, guys. I really do. Okay. And I'm just going to lay it in here. Definitely sizzling. Kind of got to have to work a little, you know. Guys, remember, we just want it to get nice and brown because we're going to finish cooking it in the oven. So you guys don't even have to worry about, you know, cooking it all the way. killed two birds with one stone, guys. Is the real deal when I tell you. So while my chicken is doing what it's doing on this side, I'm gonna come over here and clean up a little bit because I know how I feel about cleaning up as you go. Make sure you guys stay tuned. Hey Marie, remember that onion and pepper and garlic we had? I'm just gonna add the rest of that because I don't want it to go to waste. That's good flavor, vegetables, you know. So I'm just gonna put this in my skillet. And we get ready to flip our chicken on the other side. And I'm going to add a little bit of chicken broth in the bottom of our iron skillet. There we go. Just a little bit. It's going to add some more flavor. Okay, guys, it's about time for me to flip our chicken. So you guys can see everything. I'm so excited! Yes! Yes! Okay. Oh, guys, this is going to be so good! Chicken broth and our onions and our garlic. Okay, guys, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to stop my timer. We only had like 20 seconds to go. And I'm going to put it on for another 3 minutes. And this is the thing, guys. This is what I love cooking in iron, like using iron skillet. Because we're going to take our iron skillet and it's going to finish cooking in the oven. So this is almost like a one pot meal. Who knew stuffed chicken breast could be a one pot meal, but it is. So we're going to, it's on the timer left for 2 more minutes for the flip that one side. We're going to pop her in the oven. You feel me? Our oven is preheated to 350 degrees. And we're going to pop our chicken in the oven. We're going to let it cook for 15 minutes. And that time I'm going to make my rice. I already have my green beans and my smoked turkey. And our dinner will be coming together. So make sure you guys stay tuned. Thank you again for watching Amarie TV. If you haven't subscribed, do that. Be a part of the 18 family, and you guys stay tuned. Last thing, guys, I'm going to remove my toothpicks. I don't want them to go in the oven. Remember, we only put them in the oven. We only put them in the chicken so, you know, nothing will come apart. So getting ready to see my other mix. Because, guys, can I tell you how many times I done burnt myself forgetting that it's, you know, it's hot. You know what I mean? So make sure if you're doing iron skillet, guys, make sure you put them oven mitts on. Trust me. Okay, so we're going to pop this in the oven. Okay? Look at that. Doesn't that look beautiful? It's going to finish cooking in the oven. We're going to turn you off. Make sure you guys stay tuned. You don't want to miss what's next. Guys, I'm so excited. Okay, y'all, so I just took out my chicken, my bacon wrapped stuffed pepper and cheese chicken. And I was telling you guys, I have this casserole dish. I would suggest you guys invest in one. I got this one and this one was a set. The Pioneer Woman, if you guys watch Food Network, that is by her. So, and this pot over here, I just made me some rice, you know. What we're gonna do is we're gonna pour this rice right in the bottom of our casserole dish. I know how I feel about presentation. Let y'all catch mine. We got a piece of chicken breast.
Don't do it. We're gonna do it, bro.
I think.
Do we do it?
Bro. Oh! Mm. You fell in there.
Have a seat.
Oh,